Yes, as you said, our set of numbers is very good. Net income is up 6%. The dividend per share is up 7%, and we also announced a buyback yesterday evening. And then when you look at the earnings per share, they are up 8%. So you see a lot of strength in our numbers. When you look at the performance per segment, you can see that the life business has been operating very, very nicely with a record operating profit and also very stable performance on the new business. Asset management also had a very good year with an increase in third-party assets under management of 17% and also an increase in operating profit. And then when we come to P&C, yes, there was a disappointment in our industrial lines. But when you remove the industrial lines from the numbers, the combined ratio for P&C is actually very, very stable at 93.5. So that's a very good combined ratio. We made also progress on our productivity. So overall, a strong set of results. And then clearly, as we move into 2020 and 2021, we are going to focus also on restoring profitability in our industrial business.
Yeah. Can I ask you about the asset management business as well? We know this has been a difficult period for a lot of the asset gatherers in the asset management business. What changes are you intending to make at Allianz Global Partners to improve profitability from that operation?
Yeah, first of all, I would say that the performance of Allianz Global Investors is, from a profitability point of view, is pretty good. When you look, the operating profit was relatively stable compared to the prior period. Now, as we clearly want to do even better than that, we are going to look at whether we can get more efficient. So that's something where we believe there is some room for improvement. And then clearly, what is always critical for asset management is to deliver a good performance to the investors that are putting the funds into our operation. So focusing clearly on delivering good performance to our investors and also then see whether we can do further improvement on the productivity side. And we believe that we can get a little bit better compared to where we are right now.
Giulio, you've highlighted a win in the numbers today in the release, the first fully foreign-owned insurance holding company in China. But we know short-term there are problems with coronavirus, so just talk us through what you're witnessing on the ground there in China.
Yeah, what we are witnessing in China, clearly there is a slowdown right now. For example, the life side, people cannot have meetings, so agents cannot necessarily meet with customers. So we are going to see some slowdown of production. From a property casualty point of view, there is some exposure to travel, but overall, from a group point of view, I would say there is not really a material impact on our numbers. We don't expect anything major coming from what is happening right now in China. Indeed, our focus is more about making sure that our employees are safe. And so right now we are allowing clearly our employees to work from home. In the case they have to go to the premises, we're making sure that the premises are very safe from a medical point of view. And also we try to help the community in China with supply of medical masks and something like that. So I would say from a business point of view, there is some impact for the Chinese operation, but very limited on the group point of view. And again, as I was saying before, that's more about safety of people right now and not about financial impact.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Borsecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.